Fortunately, this summer we get to watch high-level NBA players compete together in the 2023 FIBA Men's World Cup. And usually during this tournament, we see some sort of standout player from the Team USA, especially lately where it feels like the quote stars of the league don't really participate too much anymore. And today let's talk about one player in particular, a player who has been huge in the headlines recently and even received praise in a tweet from LeBron James, that player being Anthony Edwards.
Yeah, between him and actually Austin Reeves lately, they've really been making some noise during the FIBA World Cup. And with them now going to 2-0 during actual play, not during exhibition play, a lot of the attention has rightfully been given to Anthony Edwards and Austin Reeves. But particularly about Anthony Edwards today, he averaged around 20 points per game during exhibition play, and he really solidified himself as their offensive leader. And despite only being 22 years old at that, he had 14 points in their first official game, and then he struggled a little bit in game two, but still played pretty well. And kind of translating what he's doing in the World Cup, and hopefully he can keep it up, and I'm pretty confident that he will. I know that he's confident that he will too. I'm hoping that he'll be able to translate that to the Minnesota Timberwolves come the NBA season. And how do you kind of feel about all that working out?
Well, yeah, I mean, one thing to remember is that this tournament, the World Cup, is completely different than the NBA. FIBA has a bunch of different rules. The game is split into four periods that are 10 minutes apiece, so there's much less time to play for what they're used to. And with that being said, it's still basketball, of course, but it's a different version of basketball. And that can be extremely challenging for players to kind of find their rhythm in that setting. And I think it shows how strong Anthony Edwards is maturing as a player. And remember, the USA men's team is full of exceptional talents, like some of the NBA's best and finest players. So you're not going to get a bunch of plays designed for you. You're not going to be shooting 20 shots a night like a lot of these players are used to. And in most of the exhibition and cup games, Ant had less than 10 shots, like in each game, playing on less than 30 minutes or so. And that's just because it has that huge roster of great players. And, you know, as a player, you have to make the most of your touches. They're very limited. It makes you play smart, thoughtfully. And that, to me, proves that he's learning how to play the game without the ball in his hands, which will be huge for him and the Wolves when we enter into next season.
I agree, but I also think that if anyone should be not afraid to be ball dominant, which he definitely is not, it should be Anthony Edwards, especially while playing for the Timberwolves. And he's even kind of asserted that while playing for Team USA in the World Cup as well. And I think Steve Kerr and their entire coaching staff, they believe in him, given that he is one of the very few that is allowed to purely isolate on their team and just be given the ball and create for himself. If you look at their game two against Greece here, he was the only guy who did take over 10 field goals. Not that he does that every game, how you talked about, but he was the only one who did take 10 or more field goal attempts. He made only 4 of them, but like I say, he's played better before. He's still a second on their team with 13 points after Austin Reeves with a team high and game high 15 points. But rightfully so, he is the one allowed to isolate and create for himself and even others here and there as well. And you already know he's more than obliged to do it. He's very confident. He knows about his ability. He wants to be that number one guy. Doesn't matter if we're talking about the NBA or even playing for Team USA. With all their talent, he wants to be the number one guy. He views himself that way. And kind of getting back to their team and the NBA itself, he's going to need to think that way and take an even bigger step forward during this upcoming NBA season for the Timberwolves to have any kind of relevancy and become a real threat. Between the really awkward fitting front court of Karl-Anthony Towns and Rudy Gobert, it's really limited how far they can go, how good they can be in the modern NBA, with two kind of defensive liabilities on the perimeter anyways with Kat and Gobert. And in order for them to overcome that, they're going to need a really big step from Anthony Edwards, even though he's already been pretty good.
No, I agree 100%. And you touched a little bit on how he has that confidence, and I think it's completely rightfully deserved at this point. Each year he gets better and better. You know, as we enter his fourth year in the league, his field goal percentage is better than the year before, three-point percentage better than the year before, and he's getting more rebounds, more steals than the year before. And obviously more shots come with that and stuff, but I'm a firm believer that Ant could be a superstar in the league, like in the next year or two. It's going to take a different level of maturing, and I think that it's also going to come at a big step for probably Karl-Anthony Towns, and I'm not sure if you agree with me here or not, but in my opinion, the Wolves need to make it extremely clear that Anthony Edwards is the guy. It's no longer Kat. He's not the guy. It's Ant. And I'd like to see Kat take kind of like a slight sidestep into not a new role, but more of a more defined role that he already kind of has. He needs to be much more poised on defense and smarter when it comes to what kind of shots he is taking. And to me, that's always been a big issue with Kat, you know, as coming from a longtime Timberwolves fan. The big issue with Kat is he often forces things on offense, and it looks junk. It looks clunky and junky. And if the squad looks to improve, not only record-wise but actual winning basketball-wise, Kat needs to kind of stop doing that. And like you said, kind of before about Ant, how he needs to take a big step also.
Yeah, and that'll kind of be the key for the Wolves this year, if they can overcome that major hurdle that they've created for themselves. You know, I'm not sure if Kat still views himself as the de facto number one option for their team. I kind of feel like he does. But then again, he's kind of the type of guy who probably wouldn't mind taking a, not even a back seat, but kind of a 1B to 1A scoring option to Anthony Edwards, right? Especially if Ant, and given that he is getting recognized for it on a worldwide level right now, that he can become their legit number one option. He kind of shared that responsibility with Kat when he was on the floor and healthy anyway last season. And while he was out, he was their de facto number one option. And I think he's really going to assert himself in that role this year. And, you know, my kind of hope for him is that he can become around a 28 point per game kind of guy this season. That would be taking about a 3.5 point per game jump, which when you're already at about 24, that's a pretty big leap to begin with. But I think in order for them to really be a threat and be viewed that way with the problem again that they created for themselves, a lot will fall on Anthony Edwards. He needs to become their de facto number one guy. And then another guy, though, that I think could help them with that would be Jaden McDaniels taking another step forward as well. He's already a top five wing defender in the NBA, and he might even be a top five defender in general, depending on who you ask. And he had a really good season last year, even offensively, too. He shot 52% from the field, 40% from three, averaged around 12 points per game. And if he can maintain that shooting efficiency while going to around 15 points per game, along with Ant going to around 28 points per game, maybe even 30 while shooting very efficiently as well, that would make me feel a whole lot different about the Timberwolves, even with the Rudy Gobert, Karl Anthony Towns front court.
I really like the comparison with Jaden and Ant kind of taking that step forward. One thing that you often kind of overlook, and I know these guys are young, but one thing you often kind of overlook is the durability of these players, right? So Anthony Edwards last season played 75 games. Jaden McDaniels, 79 games. Like, these guys are durable players. They're going to play in most of the games. They're working on their game. They're improving, especially when you have all these issues with kind of Kat too. You're going to kind of need to lean on these other players like that. And I think not only Jaden McDaniels, of course, but my thing that I really like about Jaden McDaniels that I hope the Wolves never give up is his defense. He's an incredible defender. When before they traded away Vanderbilt to the Lakers, I mean, Jaden and Vanderbilt were, I mean, they were so good, so fun to watch on defense. And I think Jaden is one of the better defenders in the league. He doesn't get a ton of credit for it. It's starting to kind of rise up, but he is a really good on-ball perimeter defender. And I think that that's, no matter what, huge for the Wolves, and they're going to have to latch onto that. But like you said, he can add some more offense to this Wolves defense, or the Wolves offense, and they're going to need it. If you look at the whole roster, I mean, it's pretty guard heavy and it's pretty center heavy, or forward, like kind of power forward heavy, especially with that Naz Reid big contract. So you're going to look to those guys. And I think Naz, I actually like the Naz Reid contract a lot. Hoping that they do something maybe with Kat or Gobert if it doesn't work out. And I don't know about you, but it feels like probably nothing will ever get done with the Gobert contract. I think it's just too big. And this just comes from a Wolves fan. I think that it can work with them, but like you say, it's a mess that they kind of made for themselves, and I'm not sure moving forward how it's going to work with those three.
Yeah, to kind of touch on everything you said there, beginning with the front court issue, no, I agree. It's, they're not going to get out of the Rudy Gobert situation, and even if they would find a team to take him on, they would get nowhere near the return they gave up. I think that's widely accepted and agreed upon. What they gave up, 3 first round picks, 2 first round pick swaps, multiple high level role players, and just really a good combination of assets to get him. They're not going to get that back. We all know that. Maybe trading Cat could be a possibility. Who knows what they'll get from him. He had an injury plagued year last year, and not a really great one by his standards to begin with either. So rightfully so, they didn't look to trade him this summer. And like I said, that's going to really force them to bank on Edwards and Jaden McDaniels, with them having over $200 million committed to their center position alone, not even their front court, between Kat, Gobert, and Naz Reid. Yeah, that's going to put a lot of emphasis on McDaniels and Anthony Edwards. And I really do like how you brought up the durability with them. That's something we often tend to overvalue. Guys have been playing over 55, 60 games nowadays is a true rarity, actually, like for a superstar player. Between load management, just little injuries here and there, serious injuries too, it's become a rarity. Maybe that'll change with the new award system requiring 65 games to be eligible for them, and hopefully it does. But that's a very important thing with McDaniels and Edwards. And McDaniels, he probably would have played nearly every game but those three if he wouldn't have, you know, injured himself by purely being that intense. If you remember during leading up to the play-in tournament, he got mad going into the locker room and he punched the side of the wall thinking it wasn't concrete behind it. And the hand lost that battle. But other than that, very durable player. I think he will take another leap forward. You know, we talked about his offense and I'm hoping that can improve. I'm not looking at a huge leap for him here because I do agree with you. They need to keep him focused on being their top dog defender, defending pretty much every position on the court, which he can do. Very few guys can do it, but Jaden McDaniels can definitely defend 1 through 4, and even in the small ball era, he can defend 1 through 5, given that their opponent's in a small ball lineup. And between him and Edwards, that's a it's a great duo to build around, and I'm starting to think that way too. Like, no longer about Karl-Anthony Towns, really building around him, building around Anthony Edwards and Jaden McDaniels.
And let me get something very clear. I really do like Kat. I like his game for the most part, but realistically, it just doesn't work with this Timberwolves squad if you're going to try and build around Anthony Edwards, which we've talked about already. At this point, why wouldn't you? Like, he's clearly going to be a really great player, superstar, and he has that capability. So you want to build around him. It's weird to try and imagine some sort of way it works out with Kat. I know I kind of said that before. So I think that even with everyone on the roster, you know, we still have guys like, I think a starting lineup could be probably Mike Conley, Anthony Edwards, Jaden McDaniels, Kat and Gobert, really, maybe, and the Nas come off. Maybe, I guess, I don't know. But here's the thing with the Nas contract, I could easily see them. I think Nas fits better in than where Kat does. And again, it's still going to be kind of weird. But I think that Nas is a little bit better of a defender than Kat is. And I think that's kind of what they need more of than more offense. But then at the same time, you sacrifice that three-point shooting that Kat kind of brings to the table, that outside perimeter threat. It's a really weird dynamic. You have other guys like Kyle Anderson, Josh Minot, Wendell Moore Jr., Jordan McLaughlin. Another one that actually played really well. The limited touches that he got in the playoffs was Alexander Walker, who shot pretty well, actually. So I think that he might be able to take, kind of like the way I think of it, like a fill role that like Malik Beasley had. I think that he could maybe fill up that a little bit to a little bit of a degree. But overall, I personally think the Wolves are probably going to be, even if everything happens that we talked about with Ant and Jaden, I think the Wolves are still going to be right around that play-in territory this coming year. And if everything works out, best case scenario, maybe a tiny bit above that. As being a Wolves fan for a while, it's hard to imagine it working out with currently what they all have right now.
Yeah, I mean, from a talent standpoint, they have a good amount of talent on their team. Like, that's hard to deny. It's really just all about the fit standpoint. And I don't have anything against Karl-Anthony Towns as a player. Yeah, he's not suited to be a defensive modern-day power forward, but they've shown that they can win games with him and not Gobert on the team together. It's just that fit issue, and that's what it comes down to here. And I think that's why they actually did lock up Naz Reid long-term. Potential backup plan for if they would trade Kat. Potentially, they could do that, and then have Naz Reid fill that role. I'm not sure they would want to pair him and Gobert in the starting lineup either. They'd probably just move McDaniels down to the four in their starting lineup. Maybe put Kyle Anderson at the three or pick somebody else up, and then Edwards at the two, Conley at the one, especially for this season. I really like the Conley fit with their team too. I know you and me have talked about this, how Mike Conley, he really helped transform their offense to become more of a, you know, really fluid offense compared to a clunky fitting. And, you know, he actually knows how to work with Rudy Gobert, how he played with him in Utah for a couple years, and just has that ultra soft touch for a playmaker and finding people open and setting people up. I love the Mike Conley fit with them, even though he is a little bit older too. It's kind of like a band-aid patch for now, but regardless, I like that fit with them. And I actually do like their young talent too. I really like the Leonard Miller draft pick. I can't believe they got him in the second round. I thought he would be a mid to late first round draft pick. I like Josh Minot. I like Wendell Moore. I even like Alexander Walker, even though he's not like a super young guy anymore, but made some noise in the play-in tournament for them, played well in the playoffs as well. Hopefully he can translate that into next season. But yeah, for like a ceiling with them, you know, for the regular season, I think they could be a really good team. Like, you can still win regular season games by being big and having a big dominant defense, maybe not very switchable one that they don't have, but they can definitely win games by playing that way. It just comes down to the postseason when teams really force them and target Gobert and Karl-Anthony Towns to make them switch on defense and defend the perimeter, high pick and roll plays. It will become difficult then. And no matter what a Rudy Gobert team has tried, they've just not been able to figure out how to hide him or make him effective on defense in that situation. And I think it's going to come down to that again. I don't see them getting beyond round one, unfortunately. But what I'm high on for the Wolves' outlook is, again, Anthony Edwards and Jaden McDaniels. And I'm really glad that Ant's getting the worldwide recognition while playing for Team USA in the FIBA World Cup right now. I think it's a really good point to look forward to moving forward for the Timberwolves, that Ant's taking that step forward, becoming their de facto number one option and a legitimate superstar in the NBA.